What's up, makeup world? I'm here with another New Year's Eve makeup tutorial. This one is featuring the Japanese pixelated palette. If you want to see how I created this, then keep watching. So first I am going in with fresh washed hands and my Urban Decay primer potion. I'm just going to spread that all over my eyelid, making a nice even base for the eyeshadow to go on. So I'm sorry, but I lost the clip. I went in with the light brown color from the Japanese palette and put that in my crease and used the beige eyeshadow underneath to just put over my entire lid. So as you can see right now, I'm going in with the black eyeshadow from that palette and I'm just carving out my crease. That way I can kind of round out where I want to put that gray eyeshadow. So I'm just blending that in, adding a little bit more color and blending. Doing it this way, it's kind of a slow process, but it's going to look nice at the end. So now I'm taking my NYX Jumbo Pencil in Milk and putting that all over my lid. That way that nice, beautiful, sparkly gray eyeshadow has something to stick to. I'm going to use both colors. That way I can get a nice dimensional look for that glitter to sit on top of. So just packing that on with a Morphe rounded eyeshadow brush. I'm just packing all of that right on to my lid. And going in with the top color now and just putting that right on top of the other shade. And that is a Morphe B83 brush. This is like the perfect size brush to pack on eyeshadow on the lid. So now I'm using an Urban Decay brush that came from one of the Naked palettes. I believe it was the Naked 2. And I'm taking some of that matte beige eyeshadow from the Japanese palette and just blending everything out. That way it looks really clean and sharp. And then I went back in with the, Morphe E18 brush and some more of that brown eyeshadow, and I'm just kind of bringing it up. And as you can see, I'm lining my eyes with a black waterproof pen by e.l.f. And I'm doing this because it's going to give the it's going to give me a stencil for where I want to put that glitter, and it's also going to make the glitter look a lot thicker. That way I don't have to use as much glitter to get the same effect. So just, it doesn't even matter how perfect and straight your wing liner is, because you're just going to go over it with the glitter anyways. And I'm just bringing it down to my inner corner. Alright, now using my e.l.f. glitter primer, I'm just going to squeeze some of that on the back of my hand. That way I can take this nice flat top e.l.f. brush and this Martha Stewart Hematite glitter, and I can dab this brush into the glitter primer and trace that line that I just drew with the eyeliner. And now, as you can see, I am taking the brush and the glitter and just putting it right along the eyeliner line. Really perfect brush to do this because it's nice and straight. I just have to stamp it right where I drew the liner. And this glitter is really pretty. It kind of has like a lavender shine to it. I'm just packing the glitter right on to where I have my glitter adhesive. If you don't have a glitter adhesive and you plan on using glitter for this New Year's, I definitely recommend the e.l.f. one. It's just a couple of dollars and it works like a champion. So I'm just going to apply some mascara and some false lashes. I don't have a preference to any mascara. I always wear false eyelashes, so I'm not looking for them to be thick or anything, just something that will give the eyelashes something to kind of stick to. So I just always trim the eyelashes to fit my eye, and then I bend them that way so that they curve to the shape of my eye. It makes it so much easier when putting them on. And these are the Ardell 134 lashes. And I just use my fingers and stick them on. I'm very comfortable with fake lashes. I wear them every day. If you're not, you can use a pair of tweezers to kind of guide them towards your eyes. I know that some of the Ilora lashes come with a little half moon shaped tweezer that you can really get in there. But I prefer to just use my fingers. And here is the finished product. Thank you guys so much for watching, and I hope you enjoyed this tutorial.